Here's continuing coverage of Governor Corbett's plan to make Pennsylvania's roads and bridges safer. Corbett says that will happen if there's a restructuring of how bridges and roads are paid for. Today, in front of the York split, he proposed cutting the state gasoline tax over 2 years and having oil companies pay more in taxes to make the roads safer.
What we're trying to do is improve our system. And in order to improve the system, we have to have a long-term, sustainable funding process.
Corbett was flanked during his announcement by a dozen Republican state lawmakers. One of the state's top Democrats says for Corbett's $2 billion plan to work, it needs support from both parties. News 8's Pete Muntean's here now with that story. Pete?
Ron, as state auditor general, it's Eugene DePasquale's job to argue for smart state spending. Tonight he told me a transportation plan increasing spending cannot get hung up by those afraid to spend because it will do the most good now. $2 billion more dollars of state money will help fix Pennsylvania's ailing roads and bridges. Democrat DePasquale insists safety cannot be a bipartisan issue. His message to financially conservative Republicans who might stall this in the state Senate, this will boost the state economy.
This is clearly a core government function, but it's also a jobs program as well. When you pump money into your roads and bridges, you can't outsource that work. You know, Pennsylvania road companies are the ones that are going to do that work, and they'll hire Pennsylvanians.
DePasquale says bipartisan support will only push the accelerator on this passing. He is hopeful it will be on the governor's desk before the legislature breaks for the summer. Ron?
All right.